Hello and welcome, guys. This is Alman from Technology, and today we're going to be doing a video on the Marshmallow update on the Xperia Z2 versus the Marshmallow update on the Xperia Z5. So we're going to take a look at both devices. We're going to see what are the differences and how well they perform. We're going to compare both of these devices against each other, and we're going to see, we're going to give you an overview of how they are different from each other. So let's go ahead and get started. So we'll turn on both devices. The Xperia Z5, however, has a fingerprint reader, so I'm just going to use my fingerprint to unlock it. And since the Xperia Z2 does not have a fingerprint reader, we're going to go ahead and manually unlock it. Now, again, I just want to show you that both these devices have a new animation kind of thing when you're unlocking both the devices using the touchpad, the pin. So I do have touch unlock on both devices. So when you press the buttons, you can see you have that nice material design kind of animation when you tap on each of these buttons. That is a new addition compared to the older ones. Both these phones have it, and as you can see, the first thing that you're going to notice is most of it is pretty much the same, except for the fact that this Google search bar over here has changed. Earlier on Lollipop, you used to have this Google search bar on every home screen, but now you only have it on the main home screen and keep this only on one home screen. You did have the option on Lollipop to hide this, but now you can remove this obviously by just dragging this and just removing this, but you can only have one search bar per home screen. So that's one of the differences that you are going to find on the Lollipop update. Of course, the task manager does look a little bit different on both these devices. It's pretty much the same, just a little bit cosmetic differences from Lollipop. And coming to another change that I found on both these devices, it's pretty much the same though. You do have a new dialer over here on both these devices over here, as you can see, a new dialer. Now I've not been using my Z5 a lot, so I don't have a lot of recent calls over here. So you see, this is a new dialer that it's in the functionality, it remains pretty much the same, though you have the frequently called contacts on the top, and you do have your call log at the bottom on both the devices. Same, a little bit colorful additions over here. We did have different colors, but this time around the theme is a little bit different. You can directly search for any contact from here. You can go ahead and search for any contact from here, and your complete contacts list is available over here. Sorry for that. Your complete contacts list is available over here on top if you tap this button, and you do get a complete list of all your contacts, your groups, and all that, your favorites and stuff. So that's similar to what we had seen in the older update. Also, one more thing I'd like to show you is my Z2 does not have a SIM card, but I can show you on my Xperia Z5. The dialer has also changed. So if I'm, for example, if I call somebody like my friend over here, so you do see that there's a big cosmetic difference over here in terms of design. You have the end call button, and it's totally different from the Lollipop update. I'm just going to end that call, and yeah, that's a little bit different from the Lollipop update. So the cosmetic differences that you will find on this. Of course, I do want to show you that both these devices are running on Marshmallow. So we're just going to go ahead in the settings. Of course, I'm going to show you the settings as we go through. The settings over here, again, we have a different color scheme and slightly different settings menu has been modified a little bit. Not a great big difference, just a few cosmetic differences. You do have some options that have been moved around here and there. The stamina mode, however, has been removed from both the devices. You do not have stamina mode anymore, but Sony has promised that they are going to bring stamina mode back again soon in a future update. So that update is going to be coming pretty soon. And some differences that I would like to spot on here, for example, you have this memory option over here that was in the Lollipop update, the memory option was there in the applications menu, but now there's a separate option for the memory so that you can manage your memory and get an idea about how much memory is used, how much memory is free. I would also like to point out that if you can see in the video, you would notice that the Xperia Z2 here has a lot of free memory compared to the Xperia Z5. I want to point that out. Even though my Z2 has a lot more apps than my Xperia Z5, there is a considerable more memory free left than it is on the Xperia Z5. So I would say that maybe the memory management on the Xperia Z5 after the Lollipop update, after the Marshmallow update, is not that great. And I would like to point out and say that Sony should take this into consideration and work on the new update so as to improve the memory management so we get more free memory. Though that does not mean that the Xperia Z2 is faster or the Xperia Z5 is slower. We'll be talking about that in the future as we move through the video. So you do get this new support over here, support menu over here at the bottom, that will show you the information about your phone. It'll show you till when your warranty is valid. Of course, the warranty on both these phones is valid. We have a warranty of till 2017 on the Xperia Z5 and a warranty till the 8th month of 2016, that is August, on the Xperia Z2. And you get a lot of other information. They've added support so you can contact support directly from your phone, and some good additions over here so you can get support from Sony in case you need some. Coming back to the about phone, we're gonna see over here, as you can see we do have Marshmallow running over here. So as you can see, we do have Marshmallow running over here on both these devices. You have Android 6.0.1, 6.0.1, and then if you tap it continuously, you might get the animation of a Marshmallow over here. Something might happen, you know, Marshmallows pop up and Androids laugh, something like that. I don't know, something funny happens. You get a game or something, or a video, or you get the Flappy Bird kind of game, okay, but with Marshmallows this time. Anyways, that is the settings menu that has changed. Of course, stamina mode has gone, and I've already told you about that. Another change over here is that the notification panel remains the same. There's no difference in the notifications menu over here. You do have a new camera interface that I would like to show you. Both these devices have got the same camera interfaces, pretty much the same camera interfaces. You have the different modes. You can select different modes by just scrolling upwards like this. On any of these devices, you just scroll upwards and you get different camera modes. Of course, you have this special modes like 4K video and all that stuff over here on both these devices. Of course, you have the fun stuff that Sony gives along with their phone. You can remove that. Now you have photos, video, superior auto mode, and the manual mode on this phone. Though I do feel that the superior auto mode on the Xperia Z5 is not that great, and I was disappointed with the picture quality of the Xperia Z5 in the superior auto mode. Though the manual mode is somewhat better, the Xperia Z5 doesn't do really good in the superior auto mode. Yeah, the flash control over here, settings, you have settings, and it's pretty much the same on both these devices. The camera menu has pretty much the same settings and stuff. Of course, the Z5 has a 23 megapixel camera, whereas the Z2 has a 20.7 megapixel camera. Okay guys, I'm just continuing through. I just want to show you the app tray over here. There is a slight difference over here between the two devices. You do have the search bar on the Xperia Z2 that's constant, whereas you do not have a search bar over here that's constant. You do have a magnifying lens over here When clicked, you can get the search bar and you get suggested apps over here. Whereas the suggested apps can be visible when you just come on the far left on the Xperia Z2. So just going back, and now we're going to take a look at, we're just going to open some apps at the same time, and we're going to see how they perform. So as you can see, we have cleared all the apps on both the devices. Now we're going to go ahead and open apps at the same time on both the devices. Okay, let's go ahead and start with the dialer. Wait, I've just arranged some apps over here on both the devices, and we're going to start with the dialer. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So the Xperia Z5 is faster over here in this regard. Just going to go back, and now we're going to open Chrome on both devices. 1, 2, 3. Of course, the Xperia Z5 faster over there on that front. And now the messaging, we're going to open 1, 2, 3. And a little slight difference between both, not a great difference, but still the Xperia Z5 doing fast. And now the camera, we're going to open the camera on both devices. 1, 2. Oh, I accidentally opened the camera over here. So sad. And 1, 2, 3. Of course, on the Xperia Z5, the camera opened faster, as you can see. And we're going to go back. Now, one thing I would like to point out is that whenever you open camera and you go to the multitasking, there is a slight glitch over here or something. I don't know why, but apparently the task manager goes in horizontal mode instead of vertical mode, even if your phone is vertical. So I don't know why that happens. Maybe Sony will correct it in a future update anyways. So the other thing next, we'll open some more apps over here. We'll try YouTube on both the phones. 1, 2, 3. Xperia Z5 faster over there. Still loading on the Xperia Z2. Xperia Z5 is through. And what else? Let's go ahead and check out Wink Music. I have on both the phones, so let's go ahead and 1, 2, 3. Of course, faster on the Xperia Z5 by a slight margin. And let's go ahead and open the Play Store. 1, 2, 3. Faster on the Xperia Z5 again. So you can see the Xperia Z5 has outperformed the Xperia Z2 in terms of applications opening. And let's go ahead and switch between apps and see how both the phones perform. Let's go ahead and open YouTube. Oh, pretty much same over there, exactly the same, no refreshing. And let's go ahead and open Wink Music, pretty much the same. And let's go ahead and open the camera again, pretty much the same. We're just going to go back home because I don't want this horizontal stuff. Again, we're going to go ahead and we'll open Play Store. Same thing, no difference in terms of multitasking between apps and the contacts. Of course, the Z5 was faster over there, whereas there was a slight refreshing on the Xperia Z2. We're going to do a benchmark now, guys. We're going to start off with AnTuTu. Let's open AnTuTu at the same time, just for the sake of it. Of course, it opened slightly quicker on the Xperia Z2. We're going to go allow. Okay, guys, now we are going to do the benchmark test on both these devices. Actually, I had to install some more stuff for the AnTuTu benchmark to take place. So I just want to show you that there's no app running in the background. Everything has been closed, and we're going to go ahead and start. Now we are obviously before I start, we're going to skip this part. So let's go ahead and start. Okay, guys, so the benchmark has been completed, and the Xperia Z2 finished slightly earlier than the Xperia Z5. However, we have a larger score on the Xperia Z5 of 70,000, and we have a 48,000 score on the Xperia Z2. However, I did notice that during the benchmark, the Xperia Z2 was struggling in the 3D benchmark test, where there was considerable frame rate lag on the Xperia Z2, whereas the Xperia Z5 fared really well and there was no lag at all. Though you can see over here in terms of 3D, like I said, the Xperia Z5 fared much better than the Xperia Z2 in terms of 3D. UX is also greater on the Xperia Z5 compared to the Xperia Z2. And however, in terms of CPU and RAM, the Xperia Z2 performs better than the Xperia Z5. So there is a slight difference between both, not a big difference, but still you have a better and higher score on the Xperia Z2 compared to the Xperia Z5 in terms of RAM and CPU tests. So we're going to go ahead and close this. I just want to test the heat that we have got from both these devices. So I have the heat application over here, just a rough check of the heat on both the devices. So over here you can see the Xperia Z2 at 38.2 degrees, and we have the Xperia Z5 running at 37.2 after the benchmarks. So we're going to go ahead and do Geekbench now. Okay guys, so I've opened Geekbench and let's go ahead and run benchmarks on both these devices in the same time. Okay, I clicked on the Xperia Z2 by mistake first. So anyways, so the benchmark has been started on both these devices. Okay guys, so we have completed the benchmark on both devices and you have a higher score on the Xperia Z5 of 1239, whereas you have a score of 907, and the secondary score you have 3986, whereas you have 2814 on the Xperia Z2. So in Geekbench, in terms of Geekbench, the Xperia Z5 outperformed the Xperia Z2. Okay guys, now we have done the benchmarks, let's go ahead and check the heat again that we have on both the devices. So you have the Xperia Z5 now heating a little bit higher than the Xperia Z2 over here, as you can see. Okay guys, so that was a comparison video between the Xperia Z5 and the Xperia Z2 Marshmallow update. Now at the end of the video, I'd like to point out that there's hardly any difference between both the devices in terms of the Marshmallow update. Both the devices look very much same, however the Xperia Z5 performs much better than it performed on the Lollipop update. The Xperia Z2 also seemed to have improved after the Marshmallow update, so I'm really happy for that. It works really well. I was kind of disappointed with the camera quality on the Xperia Z5, and I think Sony should remove some kind of patch and stuff to correct that, because the camera in low light is not performing well and the camera quality is very less. The Xperia Z5 does heat. If you are keen on knowing whether the Xperia Z5 still heats up on the Xperia on the Marshmallow update, so I'd like to say that it does heat up, but the temperature doesn't go over 44 degrees or 45 degrees. The maximum temperature will go. The Xperia Z5 is able to take, in my test, when I tested out the 4K video, the Xperia Z5 was able to take more than 4 minutes of 4K video, whereas the Xperia Z2 was able to take only 1 or 2 minutes of 4K video on the Marshmallow update. So that's where I was kind of disappointed. That's about it guys for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, do leave them in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to answer to them. And do subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Peace.